Random House Audio presents The Hidden Reality, Parallel Universes and the Deep Laws of the Cosmos by Brian Greene. Read by the author.
Preface. If there was any doubt at the turn of the 20th century, by the turn of the 21st, it was a foregone conclusion. When it comes to revealing the true nature of reality, common experience is deceptive. On reflection, that's not particularly surprising. As our forebears gathered in forests and hunted on the savannas, an ability to calculate the quantum behavior of electrons or determine the cosmological implications of black holes would have provided little in the way of survival advantage. But an edge was surely offered by having a larger brain, and as our intellectual faculties grew, so too did our capacity to probe our surroundings more deeply. Some of our species built equipment to extend the reach of our senses. Others became facile with a systematic method for detecting and expressing pattern, mathematics. With these tools, we began to peer behind everyday appearances. What we found has already required sweeping changes to our picture of the cosmos. Through physical insight and mathematical rigor, guided and confirmed by experimentation and observation, we've established that space, time, matter, and energy engage a behavioral repertoire unlike anything any of us have ever directly witnessed. And now, penetrating analyses of these and related discoveries are leading us to what may be the next upheaval in understanding, the possibility that our universe is not the only universe. The Hidden Reality explores this possibility. In writing The Hidden Reality, I've presumed no expertise in physics or mathematics on the part of the listener. Instead, as in my previous books, I've used metaphor and analogy interspersed with historical episodes to give a broadly accessible account of some of the strangest and, should they prove correct, most revealing insights of modern physics. Many of the concepts covered require the listener to abandon comfortable modes of thought and to embrace unanticipated realms of reality. It's a journey that's all the more exciting and understandable for the scientific twists and turns that have blazed the trail. I've judiciously chosen from these to fill out a landscape of ideas that, peak by valley, stretches from the everyday to the wholly unfamiliar. A difference in approach from my previous books is that I've not included preliminary chapters that systematically develop background material, such as special and general relativity and quantum mechanics. Instead, for the most part, I introduce elements from those subjects only on an as-needed basis. When I find in various places that a somewhat fuller development is necessary to keep the book self-contained, I warn the more experienced listener and indicate which sections he or she may safely skip. By contrast, the last sections of various chapters segue to a more in-depth treatment of the material, which some listeners may find challenging. As we enter those sections, I offer the less experienced listener a brief summary and the option to jump ahead without loss of continuity. Nevertheless, I'd encourage everyone to listen as far into these sections as interest and patience allow. While the descriptions are more involved, the material is meant for a broad audience and so continues to have as its only prerequisite the will to persevere. I started writing my first general-level science book, The Elegant Universe, in the summer of 1996. In the 15 years since, I've enjoyed an unexpected and fruitful interplay between the focus of my technical research and the topics that my books cover. I thank my students and colleagues at Columbia University for creating a vibrant research environment, the Department of Energy for funding my scientific research, and also the late Penty Curry for his generous support of my research center at Columbia, the Institute for Strings, Cosmology, and Astroparticle Physics. Finally, I thank Tracy, Alec, and Sophia for making this the best of all possible universes. Chapter 1, The Bounds of Reality on Parallel Worlds. If, when I was growing up, my room had been adorned with only a single mirror, my childhood daydreams might have been very different. But it had two. And each morning when I opened the closet to get my clothes, the one built into its door aligned with the one on the wall, creating a seemingly endless series of reflections of anything situated between them, it was mesmerizing. I delighted in seeing image after image populating the parallel glass planes, extending back as far as the eye could discern. All the reflections seemed to move in unison, but that, I knew, was a mere limitation of human perception. At a young age, I had learned of light's finite speed, so in my mind's eye, I would watch the light's round-trip journeys. The bob of my head, the sweep of my arm silently echoed between the mirrors, each reflected image nudging the next. Sometimes I would imagine an irreverent me way down the line who refused to fall into place, disrupting the steady progression and creating a new reality that informed the ones that followed. During lulls at school, I would sometimes think about the light I had shed that morning, still endlessly bouncing between the mirrors, and I'd join one of my reflected selves, entering an imaginary parallel world constructed of light and driven by fantasy. To be sure, reflected images don't have minds of their own, but these youthful flights of fancy with their imagined parallel realities resonate with an increasingly prominent theme in modern science, the possibility of worlds lying beyond the one we know. This book is an exploration of such possibilities, a considered journey through the science of parallel universes. Universe and universes. There was a time when universe meant all there is, everything, the whole shebang. The notion of more than one universe, more than one everything, would seemingly be a contradiction in terms. Yet a range of theoretical developments has gradually qualified the interpretation of universe. The word's meaning now depends on context. Sometimes universe still connotes absolutely everything. Sometimes it refers only to those parts of everything that someone, such as you or I, could in principle have access to. Sometimes it's applied to separate realms, ones that are partly or fully, temporarily or permanently, inaccessible to us. In this sense, the word relegates our universe to membership in a large, perhaps infinitely large, collection. With its hegemony diminished, universe has given way to other terms that capture the wider canvas in which the totality of reality may be painted. Parallel worlds, or parallel universes, or multiple universes, or alternate universes, or the metaverse, megaverse, or multiverse, they're all synonymous, and they're all among the words used to embrace not just our universe, but a spectrum of others that may be out there. You'll notice that the terms are somewhat vague. What exactly constitutes a world or a universe? What criteria distinguish realms that are distinct parts of a single universe from those classified as universes of their own? Perhaps someday our understanding of multiple universes will mature sufficiently for us to have precise answers to these questions. For now, we'll avoid wrestling with abstract definitions by adopting the approach famously applied by Justice Potter Stewart to define pornography. While the U.S. Supreme Court struggled to delineate a standard, Stewart declared, "I know it when I see it." In the end, labeling one realm or another a parallel universe is merely a question of language. What matters? What's at the heart of the subject? Is whether there exist realms that challenge convention by suggesting that what we have long thought to be the universe is only one component of a far grander, perhaps far stranger, and mostly hidden reality. Varieties of parallel universes. A striking fact, it's in part what propelled me to write this book, is that many of the major developments in fundamental theoretical physics, relativistic physics, quantum physics, cosmological physics, unified physics, computational physics, have led us to consider one or another variety of parallel universe. Indeed, the chapters that follow trace a narrative arc through 9 variations on the multiverse theme. Each envisions our universe as part of an unexpectedly larger whole, but the complexion of that whole and the nature of the member universes differ sharply among them. In some, the parallel universes are separated from us by enormous stretches of space or time. In others, they're hovering millimeters away. In others still, the very notion of their location proves parochial, devoid of meaning. A similar
range of... We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.